Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to deal with duplicates in Numbers. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you have a list of names in Numbers, but some of the names are duplicates and you want to get rid of the duplicates or maybe do something else with them. So let's start off with this list here. And you can see it's a list of random names, but right away you can spot that there are some duplicates in there. So let's start by identifying them. One way to do that is to use the match function. So we'll start off here in cell B2. I'll hit the equals key to start a formula and then we'll use match and then we can look up match over here to see the parameters. And you can see that the first is search for, then search where, and then matching method. And matching method is actually going to be important here. So let's start with what we're searching for. We're searching for the name in that row. Then where are we searching? Well, we're going to search column A for it. Then let's use just the default matching method for now. So I'll close that up and you can see that this name is found in row 2, which is correct. Let's copy that and then I'll double click on column B here just to select the cells, not the header cell, and do command V to paste. So you could see here that second one, which is a duplicate, gives us an 8 instead of 3 because it found a duplicate here in row 8. Now what would be better is it actually put a 3 here saying that this one was fine, but here in row 8 it said, oh, this is a duplicate, there's one in row 3. So we can use the matching order for that. So instead of the default matching method being find largest value, we'll go the opposite and find the smallest value. And now I'll copy and paste this throughout. And now you can see in row 3 we have a 3. But in row 8 we also have a 3. So it recognizes that the first copy of this name is actually in another row, not in the current row. So let's make this more useful by putting this in an if statement. So we'll say if, and then we'll take that matching row number there and let's compare it to the current row, which is just simply the function row without anything in it. Now if these match, in other words if we search for this name and we find it's in row 2 and this is also row 2, then this is what happens when it's true. So in this case let's just put two double quotes to actually have nothing in the cell. But if it's false, then we could say duplicate. And now if I copy this and paste it throughout, we can see that row 8 says duplicate. We can look further down and there are others here. This is a duplicate as well. This is a duplicate as well. And we could see that this name is actually here 3 times because there's 2 duplicate copies of it. Now what would be even better is if we could see where the actual original was. We can do that by altering the result here. So we can say duplicate of row and then I'm going to use the ampersand to append more text to it and then use the same match function here, paste that in, and now if I copy that and paste that throughout you can see this now reads duplicate of row 3. And we could see this is duplicate of row 14, so we could really easily find, oh, there's the original. And we could see these two are both duplicates of row 23. So now it's very useful in trying to figure out where exactly the duplicate is. Now let's say there's more than one cell that you need to compare for a duplicate. So let's insert a new column and we'll call this one amount, just some sort of other number, something else that goes along with the name here. And let me put a bunch of random numbers in here. Now let's say we only want to find duplicates where the name and this number match another row. So the way to do that is let's add another column and we'll just call this combo. And in here we'll put a formula where we just take the value of this column, then use an ampersand here and maybe a comma as a separator like that, and then the value of this column. So it kind of combines those. I'll copy and paste throughout. And now in here, instead of comparing column A, we'll compare column C. So I'll go here and I'll change this value to that, and I'll select this value and change it to that, and I'll do the same thing here, changing these just so they're in column C now rather than column A. And now if I copy and paste, you can see it no longer sees this as a duplicate of this because they use different numbers. But if I scroll down, I could see it does find this one here. You could see this matches what's in row 23. And now all you need to do is simply hide this column so you don't even notice it's there. And now you can get your duplicates listed here. Let's look at another way to do this that could be more useful in some situations. Instead of match, we're going to use COUNTIF. And this will give us the number of rows that contain this name. So here we'll use COUNTIF. And we can look that up over here. And we can see it takes a test array and condition. So the test array would be all of column A. The condition is this value here. And then we'll see it only found one of this name. If I copy and paste throughout, we can see in this case it found two of these. And also shows a two here. And then you can see here, in this case, it found three of these. And it shows that here as well. Now this doesn't play favorites as to which one's first, which one's second. It just shows you a count. What you can do with this then is filter. So with this table selected, I can go to Organize, Filter, add a filter on this second column here and say if the number is greater than 1. Now when I implement that filter, you can see it only shows me the rows where the number is greater than 1. So I can see all my duplicates. The great thing is that it hasn't resorted everything. Everything's still in the same order. Matter of fact, you can still see the row numbers here to the left. So now I can manually deal with each one of these and say which one do I want to keep. Assuming there are more columns with other data as well, you can make decisions one by one to try to figure out what to do with these duplicates. And notice if I get rid of a duplicate, like I say, oh, I want to get rid of this second copy here, I can go in, I can delete this row, and notice that the first one goes away because the count of that is now a 1 and that doesn't fit the filter anymore. So one final example. Let's say that you want to sum up the amounts that each person has but you want to take into account duplicates. So you can do that with SUMIF. So I can do equals SUMIF and let's look it up over here and we can see it's test values, condition, and then sum of values. So similar to COUNTIF but there's an extra parameter. So now we'll do for test values. We'll test column A. The condition is does it match the actual cell from column A for this row? And the sum values are going to be the amounts here. So when I use this, you can see this first one, the sum is just the same as this one row. But when I paste it throughout, you can see here, for instance, this one gives me a 97, which is the sum of 71 and 26. So both of these show a 97. So what would be useful then is to also see the duplicates here so I can eliminate them. So I can either use my match formula here or COUNTIF. So let's use COUNTIF here so I can easily see the groups of ones that are duplicates. And I'll copy that throughout. And now if I want, I could filter these like I did before. And now see which ones are duplicates. And you can notice that the sums are always the same for these duplicates. If my goal is to actually get rid of the duplicates here, what I could do is select this column here and do Edit, Copy, and then Edit, Paste Formula Results. So now instead of the actual formula being in here, you have the real number. The formula is now gone. So if I were to actually get rid of the duplicates, like say, let's get rid of row 8 here. You can see instead of having 71, I've got 97 here. I still have that number of the sum here. So I could eventually switch this to the amount column and get rid of these. So there are various different techniques for dealing with duplicates inside of numbers. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.